You're listening to the Ecosystem Approach Show. I'm Jason.
And I'm Patricia. Tune in every Monday at 1 p.m. Pacific Time and 4 p.m. Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio.
We discovered that human potential is severely limited when you program humans like a machine, which is standard practice today for self-improvement.
The Ecosystem Approach teaches you how to uncover your infinite potential by using natural methods that are truly revolutionary. Join us now for the Ecosystem Approach Show. This is the time of year when people naturally and instinctively evaluate their life. Many double down on resolutions and put effort into trying to be better by developing better habits. We have a suggestion that could really change your life. This is a part of you that has already been evaluating your life and has been giving you feedback. We are married intuitives with over 20 years experience who created the Ecosystem Approach for you. This is much different because we see human beings as ecosystems that need to be restored instead of programmed. We show you how to take an energy approach for internal discovery that is rational, practical, and useful for everyday life. Jason, are you saying that there is already a part of you that is evaluating your life? Is that what you're saying? And wait a minute, most people have never heard about this part of their life.
This part in this way.
In this way, yeah.
So most people think of evaluating your life as a thinking process. I'm gonna figure it out. I'm gonna think it through. I'm gonna write down my mission. I'm gonna make a list.
Sure.
All those things. I'm gonna create a vision board. Mm-hmm. That's because we've been programmed to think like a machine. Mm. But the truth is, if we're evaluating our life work, we look for a program to do it. You know, something that'll ask us questions, a test.
Sure.
You know, like the Cosmopolitan test. You know.
Oh yeah.
You take this test, you'll know if your husband is cheating on you, or your boyfriend is going to be the one, or all those things. You know.
You took that test, right? Oh, I meant I took that test. Sorry.
None of those. Those are all programming things. They don't work, and the reason they don't work is because they're acting like you're a machine that needs to be programmed. You're waiting for input.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you get that input, then you'll implement that input and everything will be okay. That's never how it works. And I'm sorry to be here to say that. We've been so programmed. Some of us don't even question that.
Right.
We say, well, okay, I want to evaluate my life. I'm going to Google evaluating my life on the computer. And then we'll get these questions. We'll do that. And
Everything will be okay.
Everything will be okay. We're here to tell you today that doesn't work. It doesn't give you a satisfying cha-chink. And we're going to talk about what does. But there's already an internal mechanism that you have that is evaluating your life 24/7. We call it essence. Some call it soul.
Mm-hmm.
The Ecosystem Approach teaches you to use essence because it's the center of our ecosystem. And our essence is
our own personal ecosystem.
People get confused about soul because we think about, oh, you're my soulmate. Oh, or this is my soul purpose. Or, oh, that whatever I did, that just touched my soul. But we don't think in terms of an elaborate mechanism.
Okay.
That's working on our behalf. Like, I don't want to call it a computer because it sounds too much like a machine, but it's like Mother Nature.
Mm.
You know, so when you plant something in the seed, a seed in the ground, and it grows into tomatoes or whatever you put in your vegetable garden or whatever else you want, we just kind of take it for granted. But there's a whole intelligence that creates that, and you have it. This is standard equipment. You were born with it. If you're listening today, you were born with it.
Well, and in the programming, I'm going to jump in and, you know, do what I usually do, but programming right off the top discounts that.
Yes.
It says, do not listen. Do not even look at that.
Focus on your goals. Programming says focus on your goals.
Correct.
clear away everything else, focus on your goals, mm-hmm. keep going and keep going and keep going using mm-hmm. persistence. And then that's how you achieve what you want in life. But chances are
correct.
You're focusing on the wrong goals in the first place mm-hmm. because you're not listening to this part. So right. we're going to talk about this some more. And
okay.
I came up with these two illustrations. They're very simplistic. Right. About how it's supposed to work and how it really works
okay.
based in the world today. And Colton, if you would put up the first slide, which is number 7, this is how it's supposed to work. And most of you, if you understand energy, you have, and if you're listening today, you're not watching, it's a triangle. And at the top of that triangle is your essence, your
okay.
soul.
Okay.
And your essence feeds down to your physical body mm-hmm. and your ego.
Okay.
So most people would say, well, yeah, that looks right. Yeah, what's wrong with that? Yeah, you know, and that's how it's supposed to work. But what we've discovered, again, because we're intuitive, we've been studying this for over 20 years, you know, we see that there is so much negative energy
right.
that's built up in everybody's essence, not just the people who have failed, but the people who have succeeded.
Right.
The greatest among us, even back in history, if you look at their essence, which we've done.
Yes, we have.
We can see that they still have that 80%. We call it the 80%. The 80% of their essence is encumbered with negative energy.
Or if I'm going to make that a little bit simpler, that negative energy blocks you. It lays on top of you and you don't get a clear picture about not only who you are, but what
exactly.
your purpose is and what you need or want to be doing, well, actually.
That's a great segue. So, Colton, if you would put up next image, number 8, which is the way it is now.
Yeah.
And if you just, again, if you're listening right now, just flip that triangle upside down. So you have at the base is now on the top. So your ego is on one side and your physical body is on another. And your essence is not feeding both of those.
Right.
That energy can't get to it.
Well, because it's unnatural and it's being blocked by that 80%
right.
of negative energy.
Exactly.
And by the way, 80% of negative energy, what is 80% for Jason is not the 80% for me.
It's not the same things that are blocking
me. Exactly. Exactly. I mean, we can have similar things, of course, but understand everybody is unique. And this 80% for you, well, Jason, I can't resist. I know it's the next segment, but this 80% for you is about what's blocking you, and it's blocking you if you look at your story.
So let's keep going with this, okay? So if the upside down triangle is really what's working in your life,
mm-hmm.
when you go to evaluate your life, and you look at it and say, okay, well, your ego's up here. Chances are your ego is what's evaluating your life. And your ego might tell you, oh, this year I've got to lose weight. Or this year I got to make more money. Mm-hmm. Or this year I've got to get that promotion.
Or that romance. That
romance,
partner,
yes.
Yes.
Or I'm going to change the world and go out and sell all my worldly belongings. You know,
and sit on the mountaintop.
You know, make my plan in the world or make my way in the world.
Yes.
That's coming from your ego.
Right.
And I guarantee you when your ego is upside down, in other words, when that triangle is upside down, and we're going to talk about what your ego really is. Your ego is telling you the bad information because it's not based on your essence, who you are authentically.
Right.
It's based on what your parents told you or didn't tell you. Or maybe your parents told you never amount to anything. Well, I'm going to prove them wrong. You know,
yeah.
I'm going to prove them wrong. That's all in your ego.
Mm-hmm.
People think of ego as some sort of arrogance. But the truth is your ego is what directs your life. It's what tells you what you're attracted to,
mm-hmm.
what you where your interests are,
mm-hmm.
all those things. And when that triangle's upside down, it's not being fed from your essence, who is authentically you. It's being fed by these messages from the world,
right.
these bad programming messages, you know, the bad mom that you grew up with, the bad parents that you had, or the bad school teacher that told you, oh, you're never going to learn math. You're never going to be good at math. You know, I'm saying that because that
was one of the things I learned early on, and it's just not true. And how I figured it out was by removing the negative energies, and it kind of popped up one day. I don't know how else to describe it.
It's a great example because we've been clearing the negative energy and all of a sudden she's doing math in her head, which is, if you knew her, you know how crazy that sounds. But anyways, so we'll talk about that, another time. But so if you're evaluating your life in traditional ways, it's almost a sure thing that it's coming from your ego that's not tethered by your essence.
Correct.
That's a biggie. Mm. And the other thing is that your ego often comes from, is if it's upside down, which chances are if you're listening today, it almost certainly is, that it's not being fed by your essence. See, the way it's supposed to be is that when your essence, who knows your soul purpose,
correct,
who is your soul and says, this is what you're here to do.
Right.
When your ego is there to help you implement that purpose, that knowing, mm-hmm. Knowing who you are authentically. And when we say that, when you know who you are authentically, there's a confidence in that.
Well, that's what I was going to say. When the triangle is right side up, you have access to the energy of confidence and clarity and courage. But when it's the other way around, we lack it, or we use way too much and we miss a lot.
When the triangle is upside down, you can get messages that, I'll never make that, or I'm not good enough for that. Or,
right. That's true.
You know, I'll never have any money. I'll never have a relationship. I'll never be healthy. All those things,
right.
Your essence would never say that to you. No. Your essence, if it didn't have that negative energy, said, you can do this and you can do that. And you'd be full of I can. And sometimes your ego really is arrogance. You know, sure. Elon Musk is a great example today. Okay. You know, he's got that bluster, which is phony too. Comes from, I'm going to prove everybody wrong. I'm going to prove you guys.
If you went back in Elon Musk's story, you would see exactly what that arrogance
where that came from
all about.
Exactly. We're going to talk some more about that in the next segment.
Yes, we will.
So should we?
I've
got a feeling we're way behind on time.
I forgot to set my clock, everybody. It's
so Colton, can you just send me what the time is?
Yes.
We know you really don't do that, but yes.
Let's do the key points here.
Okay.
All right.
The biggest trap is to use your ego that is out of control versus mm-hmm. your essence
mm-hmm.
that directs your ego.
Yes.
Evaluating your life in traditional ways, you are doing it with your ego without being connected to your essence.
Correct.
That can only give you bad information.
Correct.
And your ego has bad judgment, bad timing, makes choices that sound good but are not good for you personally.
Correct.
You know, if you've ever gotten divorced, you know, you kind of know. Anyways.
Yes.
So the ecosystem approach teaches you to put your essence in the proper place so you can be the center of your life for your unique empowerment.
All right. In the next segment, we're going to talk about the specifics regarding how your essence is already evaluating your life and how you can understand what it is saying to you. Your essence knows better than any expert or authority because it's uniquely you. This is the Ecosystem Approach Show with Jason and Patricia, and you're listening to Transformation Talk Radio. This is the Ecosystem Approach Show with Jason, and I'm Patricia. And in this segment, we're going to talk about the specifics regarding how your essence is already evaluating your life and how you can understand what it is saying to you. Your essence knows better than any expert or authority because it is uniquely you. We are married intuitives with over 20 years experience who created the ecosystem approach for you. It is much different because we see human beings as ecosystems that need to be restored instead of programmed. We show you how to take an energy approach for internal discovery that is rational, practical, and useful for everyday life. Jason, explain to the audience how your essence or their essence is already evaluating their lives and giving them messages.
It's this simple. All you have to do is look at what your life right now, just kind of lay it out for yourself and see what's happening. It's almost too simple.
Yes.
The problem is
okay.
Is the interpretation. And we're going to talk about that. But even when you're not listening to your essence, it creates circumstances around you to communicate to you.
Mm-hmm.
Your essence is always talking to you.
Right.
So if you're struggling with, if you just got divorced, for example, or you're sick, maybe you have a chronic disease,
mm-hmm.
illness, even a condition. Maybe you've been struggling with money, and you don't think you should be struggling with money. All those things, it's all right there. Now, I realize there are things that are beyond your control, and that's where the interpretation comes. So we're going to talk about that.
Okay.
You know,
I want to jump in and say I have a perfect example of ego, and I'm talking about my ego, which is
out of control.
What? Huh? Anyway, when I first met Jason, one of our very first conversations was about energy.
Yeah.
And I had been taught, programmed to believe that energy should be thrown out into the world. In other words, get rid of the energy and just throw it away. Well, Jason it was the other way around. It was that I was supposed to put it into the ground. I apologize.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I was supposed to put it into the ground. And Jason said, no. You just take it and you throw it out. Well, we both discovered, and through a little bit of time, we needed to put that negative energy into something, i.e. the processor.
And
that's where the processor really came
from. We're going to show you a picture of that coming up.
Yes.
But, that's where... When it's untethered by your essence.
Correct.
When there's so much negative energy, you don't get good information.
No, exactly.
And so if you're evaluating your life right now, I guess what we're trying to say is that it's not something that you do.
Correct.
People think evaluating my life, it's something I'm going to do. It's something I'm going to think through. It's something I'm going to write down.
Right.
I'm going to journal, whatever it is.
Right.
It's an energy process.
Mm-hmm.
When you start clearing away the negative energy.
Yeah.
Look, if you take your life the way it is now and say, okay,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to clear away the negative energy and I'm going to interpret what's happening to me right now in a Correct. Way that makes sense. Now, the interpretation is the key. It's not black and white. Maybe you have a bad relationship. Maybe you have a financial problem.
Sure.
Maybe you have health that's not good.
But when you look at that, most of us just want to look at what's right in front of us.
Yes.
But the bottom line is that look back. And I realize it's very, very painful.
Well, and when you look back, that's an energy process. So let me explain. Okay. You know, you can't, we had someone close to us recently said, I need more money because I'm never having enough. I'm always running out of
Correct.
Money at the end of the month. I run out of money for food, things like that. What's the problem? Well, mm-hmm. She thinks she needs more money, but we can see again, because the energy has been cleared, is that it's not a money problem. It's not an amount problem. It's a problem with, she uses spending to make yourself feel good.
Yeah. It's an emotional problem.
And that need to feel good comes from a form of unworthiness.
Correct.
And programming that you received as a child.
Mm-hmm.
It's, for someone else, they may have a money problem that's completely different.
Correct.
You know, but, you need to clear away that energy. That dark energy always right. skews your perception.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're trying to be in the world without using energy processes and
Correct.
Trying to see the world the way it is, you know, the people that say, I'm objective, I don't believe in this energy, hoo-ha, you know, I'm objective. The truth is, objective people cannot be objective.
Not completely.
No.
Because the essence of life has a tendency to knock you off your feet.
People who say that they're objective and they're usually stubborn, they're usually, they think they know it,
mm-hmm.
and they think they have this objective clarity that isn't really true.
Mm.
So
it's boxed in.
It's boxed in. And the only way that you remove that boxed in is to remove the negative energy.
Correct.
So, here's another point that I want to make.
Okay.
So you lay out your life and say, oh my gosh, my life's awful. You know, my life's awful. Well, dark energy.
Negative energy.
always takes the message from the essence and turns up the volume and makes it worse than it really is.
Correct.
So if you look at your life right now and you say, okay, well, it's the dark energy is turning it up. Again, how do you get rid of dark energy? Well, it's an energy process. Moving negative energy, correct, whether it skews your perception of the way when you're trying to evaluate your life or not, it's your way of seeing your life more objectively.
And I just want to add, yes, it can be painful, but you can also clear that pain so you can have even more clarity about your life.
Exactly. Most people say, I don't want to go back there. I had a really bad childhood. I don't want to look at that anymore.
Correct.
And it's not about looking at it really. It's just a matter of saying, okay, what is my emotional story? And we've done so many shows about your emotional story, but your emotional story is how you felt about how you grew up, not about what happened to you,
correct,
how you felt about it.
Mm-hmm.
Two people could have the same life path or similar life path and feel differently about it and respond.
One of my sisters and I, we were very close in age and we grew up together. That's exactly the way it happened.
Their perception of the way things were are completely different. And it's partly because her mother treated you differently than treated her, you know, but in order to see that, you don't figure those things out. You see it by taking away, removing the negative energy.
Correct.
And seeing the way it really is.
Correct.
You know, a lot of people, this is a classic, you know, they're trying to find a mate. And we've had so many people.
Yes, this is a big one.
Talk to us about this over the years. I'm trying to find a mate. Oh, there's nobody out there. There's no good mates available.
I've looked everywhere. I've done all those things. Go ahead.
You know, and chances are, if you look in your emotional story, you see, okay, what's there? What's the negative energy that's attached to me uniquely?
Correct.
That's creating that barrier that's keeping me because.
Exactly. And the example of that is the bottom line is I know this person whom their mother kept telling them, well, you're not good for anything except, having children. And but you know what? You're never going to find the right mate. Because, who's ever going to want you?
That programming is an energy. That programming is an energy. And if you start removing that, think, oh, my gosh. That programming, where does it sit? In your ego that's not connected to your essence. So if you can, and again, those two triangles, upside down triangle and the right side up triangle.
Correct.
That's very black and white, and it's not that way.
Exactly.
You know, it doesn't like flip all of a sudden and go back and, you know, that sort of thing. But if you understand that the more negative energy you remove from your essence, the more likely that you can see your life clearly, you can see what the problem is, and then you can see the energy that's in your way and clear it.
And when he's talking about the energy, he's talking about the hurt, the hate, the anger, the fear. I mean, I can go on and on and on. The point that I'm getting at is that when you start using the ecosystem approach, then you really start to recognize those energies and you can do something about it.
Some of those things are just intangible. She mentioned emotions.
Yes.
But let's say you're not likable. Let's say that.
Okay, that's a good one.
You know, the opposite of the Midas touch. You have it where everything you touch is a financial.
Doesn't turn to money.
Is a financial dud. Yes, exactly. You know. What if you're a klutz and you keep getting into accidents?
Correct.
You know, that cause problems that block you in your life.
Yes, exactly.
It's all energy.
Exactly. And the bottom line is this is from my own personal experience. The best way out is to start using the ecosystem approach because I guarantee you somehow, some way you're in pain right now. And I'm talking about mostly emotional pain. And even if it's physical, and the ecosystem approach really can help you with that. It's amazing. So
we take care of my mom who's got dementia and she just recently had shingles and it's been,
it's very painful,
awful to watch. And because she has dementia, she can't hear, it makes caregiving and helping her even more difficult.
It is.
But one of the things that I see is that pain is also an energy.
Yes.
And we've been starting to clear that and it has amazing, amazing results.
Exactly.
One last point. Okay.
Okay.
Your ego always wants to take action. Well, what do I do about it? I see my life in front of me. It's awful.
Okay.
So what do I do about it? This is not, I'm saying the way to evaluate your life, evaluate it, remove the energy, keep removing the energy.
The negative energy.
And it'll start to reveal itself to you.
And then you can do something about it.
Yes. And, okay. And the action will follow naturally and organically.
Exactly. Jason, what are the key points?
Your essence creates circumstances in your life to communicate to you and give you feedback.
Correct.
Oh my gosh. You know, your ego always wants to take action, but it's far better to just start removing the negative energy. And your ego always wants to take action, but just start removing the negative energy related to your life circumstances.
I love that.
It's not just generic negative energy. The ecosystem approach is designed to make essence useful and restore it to its natural function for human beings.
In the next segment, we're going to talk about our suggestion for the new year and the specifics regarding what you can do to make this the best year ever. This is the Ecosystem Approach Show with Jason and Patricia, and you're listening to Transformation Talk Radio. This is the Ecosystem Approach Show with Jason, and I'm Patricia. And in this segment, we're going to talk about our suggestion for the new year and the specifics regarding what you can do to make this the best year ever. We are Marriott Intuitives with over 20 years experience who created the Ecosystem Approach for you. This is much different because we see human beings as ecosystems that need to be restored instead of programmed. We show you how to take an energy approach for internal discovery that is rational, practical, and useful for everyday life. Okay, Jason, what are you going to suggest for the audience in this new year?
You know, it's more than just the new year. And
it's a good start.
If I had more time, I would have changed the wording of this. It's actually for the rest of your life.
Okay.
And I'm really excited about it.
Okay.
It's time to think big.
Oh.
I woke up this morning and it was just before Patricia staggered into the room. And, you know, I get up sooner and she gets up just after me. And there was a rerun of Ancient Aliens. And yes, I listed that show. And there's some things that are way out, and we use our intuition to say, okay, is that right? Does that sound right?
Exactly.
You know, and that sort of thing. But the fact that there's people from other worlds,
the possibility of people from other worlds.
We're not going to mince words. We know it. That's true.
Exactly.
You know, when people say that to us, our intuition says,
we know that.
Yeah. That's no biggie. So we know it's there. I mean, we're not ready.
No.
And if you're listening right now, there's something special about you personally. And
correct.
I just want to say that.
I agree with that.
And you want more.
Mm-hmm.
And
more information, more understanding, more knowing.
You want to be ready.
Yeah.
And this doesn't matter whether you're 20 or 80.
Correct.
There's something that you want to open up, a part of yourself that you want to open up. And there's something may not even be able to define it. Your ego may be operating here and saying, oh, I need to lose some weight, or I need to do this, or I need that. But what you really want, what your essence really wants is to be on top again and to start talking to you and working.
Mm-hmm.
And the best thing you could do for now and for the rest of your life is to start healing, removing that negative energy.
And healing. I like what you said about that. Healing the scars and the pains of the past.
Of your essence.
Of your essence.
The most important part of you, the most fundamental part of you needs to be healed and have that negative energy removed. And the truth is, for us, we've been doing this for over 20 years now. Now it's 2023, so we can say it's 23
that's
years.
Correct.
We started in 2000, probably a little sooner than that. But
actually, in 99, that's right.
We would never think to sit down and evaluate our life. And the reason is because that's not because we don't care.
We do care, but
we're doing it every day.
Exactly.
Every day we're at the point where this negative energy, at some point, you start removing it. It's like, oh my gosh. It's like an oh my gosh moment almost all the time,
mm-hmm.
because the more we clear, the more we see,
mm-hmm.
and the more understanding we have, it's so exciting. I can't, you know, I wish I could really communicate to you. You know, maybe I need to jump up and down and do a dance or something, but I would love to be able to communicate how exciting it is as you start to remove this negative energy.
Well, and I, you know, one of the major points here that I think is really important, granted, I'm different than Jason, but if I look back on those 23 years, one of the things that I see is that where I was 23 years ago and just my ability alone to like myself was, well, let's put it, it's
non-existent.
Non-existent. Let me just say, and today that is not the way it is. Now, don't get me wrong. I can go up and down. Well, we all know that has to do with my fourness. But the bottom line is that I know that there's something here in me. I'm touching my chest and knowing that I have the ability to do something amazing because that's part of my soul purpose.
And when you're doing that stuff that comes from your heart, from your soul.
Correct.
It's your life is different.
It's awesome.
There's a wonderment that's mm-hmm. hard to describe.
Yes.
And the reason we created the ecosystem approach was so everyone could get to that place.
Exactly.
And you know, if this is giving you goosebumps right now, mm-hmm. I'm going to, it's not meant to be commercial, but go to our website right now, mm-hmm. sign up for a free section. It's all free. TheEcosystemApproach.org. We have a free section. We have free content. You'll get our weekly newsletter with all the clearings.
Correct.
The clearings is what, if you do the clearings every week, you start to remove this negative energy.
And I do the clearings every day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, we both do. I mean, we're doing clearings daily. A lot of times we get together and clear. Mm-hmm. We have a hard day. We get together with each other and we start clearing. Everything is revolved around this energy, but it's amazing.
Yes.
And I can't imagine, I would never go back, even to be younger, that 23 years or whatever it is.
Correct.
Because I didn't, compared to how I feel today, mm-hmm. compared to how it feels to have that part of you awake. And if you're listening to this and you're younger in your 20s or 30s, and I realize because we're old,
that thing's young to us,
but oh my gosh, if you started now.
Okay. Yes. Yeah. But there's something else here, and you just said it. The bottom line is Jason and I don't feel the same way that other people our age feel about themselves,
right?
And life,
right? We don't feel old. Nope. We don't feel constrained. I was listening to my brother-in-law the other day saying, "Oh my gosh, it everything hurts." You know,
right.
You know,
yeah.
We don't feel that way, nope. And you know, we have our stuff. But sure. all that stuff is our hints to say, oh, you need to change that stuff and make it into an energy and then remove it.
Correct.
And it tells us the path forward.
And one more time, it's awesome.
It's,
and start today. I can't even begin to tell.
There's not enough everyone. Adjectives. Awesome, no, great, exactly, amazing. They're exactly. all been used, but it's you can't explain this.
Exactly.
So how do you do that in practical terms?
Okay.
Focus on removing the negative energy in your life every single day. Mm-hmm. There's more to happen when you remove that negative energy than trying to do some sort of self-help program. And right. that's, I'm saying that because I've done them all. I've done, not them all, but there's, I've done so many.
Close.
I wish I could have that time back. You know, the 20 or 30 years of doing all those self-help, trying this.
And I'm going to say it's time to just focus on removing the negative energy. One of the things I did and right in the beginning was I took a sticky and I wrote down the things that were bothering me and I stuck it on the mirror so I wouldn't forget or get so involved in everything.
And then clear it every day.
And then I cleared it every day. Things started changing for me at a speed I did not have any idea could happen.
So start with your emotional story and your Enneagram type.
Yes.
And then wait for the little emotional nudges.
Yes.
They come more. And the more you do this, the faster they come.
Yes.
The more nudges you get. Mm-hmm. And don't focus on goals. Focus on the negative energy that's correct. Keeping you from your goals.
Exactly.
You know, your goals will lay themselves out in front of you and say, hey, you have to do this.
Right.
Your essence will tell you what you're supposed to be doing. You don't have to worry about that. Right. You don't have to create goals. Usually, if you're just creating goals, it's coming from your ego that's untethered from your essence.
Correct.
Start clearing away, and it'll start coming where it's supposed to.
Right.
And let's do the key points and tell them how to clear.
Okay, we can do that. Jason, what are the key points?
It's time to focus on removing the negative energy in your life.
Right.
And if you hear the angels singing right now, it's because
it's not your dead.
They're trying to talk to you.
Correct.
Start with your emotional story and your Enneagram type, and then wait for the little emotional nudges.
Correct.
Don't focus on goals. Focus on the negative energy that's keeping you from your goals.
I love that.
And the ecosystem approach teaches you to remove negative energy so that your essence can be at the top of the triangle. And if you want to see those two pictures again,
correct.
And we have it's all written down on the bottom, go to our website, theecosystemapproach.org. It's in our free section. You can download them and look at them. You can post them on your mirror or your wall, or whatever.
Right.
And again, theecosystemapproach.org.
Love it. So, Jason, for those who have never listened to the show before, or those that just need reminder, let's teach everyone how to remove negative energy.
It's very simple. You can do it any posture. You can be standing, sitting, laying down, walking. We always do, we're clearing all the time, doing two things at once.
Correct.
You know, whether it's she does cooking, when we go for our walks in the morning, we're clearing with each other, talking, you know, we do it all the time. So your posture doesn't matter. You don't have to be reverent.
Okay.
It's not like a prayer. You know, it's like, oh, please, please.
No.
Your essence wants to help you. All you have to do is remove the negative energy. Right. And you don't have to say, please, will you help me? It will.
Yes.
Yeah. It's the way it's designed. It's organic. It's natural. And so so when we say, and to eliminate, we say it's a statement. And then we say to eliminate. That's the verb. And in your mind's eye, take the emotions, the energies, or the veils and illusions or barriers, whatever we say to remove, gather them up in your body and then blow them gently into that processor.
Correct.
Colton, if you put that picture of the processor up, that's what it looks like. Yes. If you want to know what the processor looks like and you're listening right now, go to our website, sign up for that free section.
Correct.
We're going to tell you about that in the next segment too. So stay tuned.
Okay. And then after we do that, we're going to activate life force energy, the most powerful energy that anyone has access to. And what we're going to do is we're going to call upon it. We're going to ask it to come in through the top of our head. We're going to let it go all the way through our body. It's going to heal as it's going through our body. Then we're going to ask it to stop at our toes. We don't want it to go into the earth, like that first argument, so to speak. And what we're going to do is we're going to pull up all the negative energies left over, and we're going to throw them in that processor that that is on our website.
Yes, that processor, we created that because it takes the negative energy on the top,
right,
processes it, and it comes out neutral.
Okay.
That's the way you're supposed to deal with negative energy.
Exactly.
Okay.
Stay tuned. When we come back, we're going to help you to start removing the negative energy so you can begin evaluating your life in the best possible way. This is the Ecosystem Approach Show with Jason and Patricia, and you're listening to Transformation Talk Radio. This is the Ecosystem Approach Show with Jason, and I'm Patricia. And in this segment, we're going to help you to start removing the negative energy that you can, so you can begin to evaluate your life in the best possible way. Jason, you ready?
Here we go. I direct all my resources and all dimensions to eliminate the barriers so I can see that the negative energy prevents me from evaluating my life objectively.
Yes.
It's not something you do. With a negative energy there, you can't see it clearly.
Right.
Start clearing the negative energy.
You
it's
will
that
be
simple.
So amazed.
Take a breath. You're clearing the barriers. You're removing the barriers. Yes. So you can see the negative energy. Yes.
And I'm going to shorten it up now just for time-wise. And to eliminate the barriers so I can see trying to, quote, figure it out doesn't work because accurate perceptions are blocked. Take a nice breath and throw it away.
And to eliminate any intense feelings of worry, anxiety, and stress I have that block my ability to listen to my essence.
Take a breath. Throw it away.
And your essence, it doesn't scream at you. You know, there's things that I just know.
That's right.
You know, and I'll, you know, someone will ask me a question, I just know. And that's my essence talking to me. It's not, mm-hmm. it's not an elaborate process. It's not like I have to sit and say, what, you know, it just comes to me. And,
okay.
And Patricia's a little bit different in how it comes to her, but it's, you know, you'll know.
You will. So, moving along, and to eliminate any, intense feelings of worry, anxiety, and stress I have that block my ability.
That was mine. That was mine. Yeah.
Then I'll do the next one. And to eliminate any feelings of fear, hurt, and shame I have about my life that probably come from ego disconnected from my essence. Take a breath. Throw it away. You don't need that energy at all. Jason?
And to eliminate the barriers so I can see the buildup of negative energy creates the upside down triangle where my ego is out of control.
Correct.
It's not giving me good information. Correct. It's sabotaging me.
Yes. Take a breath and blow it out. And to eliminate the barriers so I can see that the upside down triangle where ego is disconnected can create bad feelings and unworthiness that is not accurate. By the way, this happens to be this is my biggest one ever.
Yes.
Nice and easy. Take a breath. You don't need it. Throw it away.
We've had so many people come to us over the years saying, help me see the bad guys. Help me see the people in my life that aren't serving me. Well, the first one is always you.
Yeah.
You know, remove that negative energy attached to you.
Correct.
Okay. So, and to eliminate any feelings of fear, fear and terror that I have about my life that can just be removed.
Take a breath and blow it out. And to eliminate the barriers so I can see that energy can block accurate perceptions, and removing bad energy is essential. Take a breath, easy, and throw it away.
And to eliminate any resentment that I have about feeling bad about myself mm-hmm. that comes from my out of control ego.
Yes, take a breath.
It doesn't have to be arrogance. It can be the opposite of arrogance. Yes.
Exactly. And to eliminate any resentment I have.
Resistance.
Oh, excuse me. And to eliminate any resentment and resistance I have about feeling bad about myself.
No, that was mine.
Oh,
I'm not doing this right.
And to eliminate any resistance I have to seeing that my essence is the best source to evaluate my life. Maybe that was the problem for me. Take a nice breath and blow it away.
And to eliminate the veils and illusions so I can see that I can't think or evaluate when too much negative energy is present.
Yes. Take a breath. Or read the list. Okay. Yeah. And to eliminate the barriers so I can see that the best life evaluation process is continuous by applying the ecosystem approach. Take a breath and blow it out.
And to eliminate the veils and illusions so I can see that removing negative energy constantly will give me insights and direction all the time, continuously.
Yes.
We're designed that way. That's natural to us.
Exactly. Take a breath. And now we're going to activate some life force.
Okay.
So it goes like this. I direct all my resources in all dimensions to activate life force energy so I can use life force energy for all that I need, want, desire, and deserve, not to mention, so I can see how the ecosystem approach can help me starting today. Nice and easy. Take a breath. You're going to pull in that life force energy. Let it go all the way to the tips of your toes. You're going to stop it right there. You're going to ask it to turn around and blow it out. But in all of that, it's going to start healing where all that negative energy has been stored in your physical body. Take a breath again and blow it out. Jason?
And to activate life force so I can have hope to see and perceive my life more objectively by removing the bad energy.
Mm-hmm. Pull it in. Let it start to heal you right now, today. By the way, that comes naturally, and blow out any negative energy left over. And to activate life force so I can trust that my essence can guide me and advise me on the best path for my life. Oh, that's amazing. Pull it in and blow it out.
And to activate life force so I can decide to focus on removing the bad energy so I can perceive my life accurately.
I love it. Pull it in and blow it out. And last one, and to activate life force so I can be happy and healthy, have fun, have laughter and love and love, and be able to perceive what the energies are that are standing in my way, that are blocking me from not only what I'm supposed to be doing here, but what and but who I am. And I guarantee you, there's love there for yourself. It's just been hiding. Nice and easy. Pull that positive energy in. Let it go all the way to your toes. Now pull up any negative energy left over and throw it away. You don't need it. Jason, what are we going to talk about next week?
So we're going to talk about the dysfunction of the other side.
Oh,
and what that means exactly is people think, most people that are listening today understand that there's multiple dimensions, mm-hmm. that we live in the physical dimension.
Correct.
That we can touch things, feel things, not feel things, but you know, we can, they're tangible. There's a tangible Correct. World, but there's also an intangible world.
Yes.
That's where these emotions come from. That's where the intangibles come from. That's where they're ghosts, guides.
Okay.
You know, I know there are people that have done a whole body of knowledge based on channeling from someone on the other side.
Yes. Oh, yes. Absolutely. But
there's a lot of misconceptions about it. And this is going to be a fascinating show if you understand it.
Oh, I think so too.
Because most people don't understand. Mm-hmm. They think the other side is pure. That yes. once we go to that other dimension, everything's love and light. It's not. And we're going to talk about that. And this is going to be a fascinating show. You have to listen to this.
Exactly.
So today, if you're getting those goosebumps, if you're saying, oh my gosh, you know, I need to start removing this negative energy because my ego has been talking to me,
Correct.
Been guiding me all my life. And Correct. And I know that it's off.
Yes.
I know it's not giving me the good information.
Okay.
It's this simple. Okay. We've made it simple. It's free. Okay. All you have to do is go to our website right now, mm-hmm. theecosystemapproach.org. Mm-hmm. Sign up for our free section. Mm-hmm. You'll get the clearings that we did today. Mm-hmm. Every week you'll get the clearings that we do from the show there and
right.
and a little bit of blurb, you know, backstory about the show. And listen to our show every week.
Right.
You know, it's do that simple. Do the clearings, listen to our show,
yes.
and you're going to get started. And all of a sudden, things are going to start to happen for you.
Exactly. So
the other thing I want to ask you to do is to go to our Facebook page,
yes.
theecosystemapproach.org. And we have our videos there. This show is a video, and it'll be posted there. Like us if you're there. Okay. We really appreciate that. Mm-hmm. And leave us a comment about how you felt about this.
And suggestions for shows can go there as well.
Yes.
So we'll connect next week, Monday at 1 p.m. Pacific and 4 p.m. Eastern Time. This is Transformation Talk Radio, and you're listening to the Ecosystem Approach Show with Jason and Patricia.
Remember, your ecosystem is the most important one in the world.
Thank you for listening to the Ecosystem Approach Show with Jason and Patricia. I'm Patricia. Tune in every week as we discuss practical ways to apply the ecosystem approach and develop your potential to live your life on your terms. For more information, visit our website at theecosystemapproach.org.